Rage Against the Machine are well known for their powerful and rough style. Let's take a look at their drum sound. Art of Drumming is not just a YouTube channel, but also a free platform where you can find numerous drum-related courses filmed by major international artists. Head on over and join our growing community. The next addition to our Recreating Iconic Drum Sounds video series is Brad Wilk's outstanding performance for Rage Against the Machine's song Killing in the Name. Let's have a listen to the original recording, released in 1992. Some of those that work forces are the same that burn crosses. Some of those that work forces are the same that burn crosses. You do what they told you. And now you do what they told you. And now you do what they told you. And now you do what they told you. You're under control. The first official single release of the American rock band Rage Against the Machine features only the instruments in the band: drums, bass, guitars, and vocals. Unlike other bands that use a lot of overdubs with synths and other sounds, the rough sound of a simple rock band is what characterizes the music of Rage Against the Machine. Paired with highly political lyrics, the rough, aggressive energy is what drives the song and makes it stand out. Brad Wilk supports this energy with his drumming. You can really hear him laying everything he has into his drums. The song surely is one of the most powerful performances of the 1990s. In an interview, Wilk once stated that he decided to remove the rack toms and use only a single floor tom for the recording process of their debut album. In addition to that, he placed two cowbells to fill the spot of the rack toms. We went with our Gretsch Renown kit and did the same. The 22-inch kick drum is fitted with a clear Power Stroke 3 head for a very clear attack. For the Rezo head, we decided to cut a pretty large hole. Instead of making it perfectly round, we decided that not giving a shit about the shape of the porthole would suit the music and optics a lot better. With some muffling inside the kick drum, this is what we ended up with. The snare drum we picked is a solid aluminum 14x5 by Gretsch. The pretty thick aluminum shell gives us the right power we need. Some sources say Wilk played one of Tama's legendary bell brass snares on the record, but since we don't own one of these, the aluminum drum is as close as we can get. With a single ply ambassador coated drum head tuned to a medium range, and a single crown gel for muffling, this is our snare sound. The only drum left is one 16-inch floor tom. To get the right attack, we picked a clear double-ply Emperor batterhead. With two mini muffs to shorten the tom sound, here's the result. Looking back at live videos from the early 90s, you can see Wilk using a completely different cymbal setup from what he uses today. We decided to go with his old setup and went with a hi-hat, ride, three crashes, and a china. The cymbals from left to right are 14-inch hats with an A new beat top and an A custom bottom, an 18-inch A medium thin crash, a 20-inch A medium ride, an 18-inch A custom crash, an 18-inch K special dry china, and a 20-inch A medium thin crash. One important part of this setup is still missing, the two legendary cowbells played in the intro of the song. Now before we get into the performance, let's quickly look at the miking. The bass drum is recorded with one single mic, a TGD70. In addition to that, we used 5 M201s for snare top and bottom, the floor tom, as a room mic, and as an additional mono worst mic, placed above the bass drum. The overheads are two MC740s, and for the hi-hat we chose a ribbon M160. Now that we have the setup completed and everything in place, here's Pascal's version of Killing in the Name.
Thank you.
that work forces are the same that burn crosses. Some of those that work forces are the same that burn crosses. Some of those that work forces are the same that burn crosses. Some of those that work forces draw the same that burn crosses. Killing in the name of. Killing in the name of. Now you do what they told ya. Now you do what they told ya. Now you do what they told ya. And 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 now you do what they told ya.
We will upload the full performance with a drums only version in a separate video, so keep an eye out for that. Rage Against the Machine's whole signature sound is not about having an overproduced studio sound, but about capturing the unfiltered emotions and the amazing rough energy of their music. How do you like their sound, and what are your thoughts on our recreation? Let us know in the comments, check out all the other episodes, and make sure to subscribe to our channel for more additions in the future.